But as we continue also to fact check some projects captured on government's delivery tracker website, we take you to Kumasi. Some checks there have revealed that a Bibiani Logging Limited project captured in the NPP's 2016 manifesto tracker as completed does not exist. Managers of the over 40-year original Bibiani Logging and Lumber Company Limited located at Kasi say they've not received any support from the government for any project on their premises. Meanwhile, a UniJ garment company listed as completed at Asqua, also in Kumasi, was found to be at the ground stage. Live FM's Erastus Asaridonko has been finding out more.
Listed under Asqua Municipal Assembly on the NPP's 2016 manifesto tracker is the completion of a wood product manufacturing company, Bibiani Logging Limited. We took a trip to the company's premises.
We have gone in there, we've spoken with management, and what we have been told is that there is no such project instituted by government here at the premises. What they tell me is that they put in an application for funds to restructure the company under the 1D1F, but then they have not received any response. And so they cannot say government has sponsored any project at all here at the Bibiani Logging Limited. They are surprised that it's captured under the government projects at the Asuqua Municipal. So as we speak, we can confirm that the government project listed under Asuqua Municipal Bibiani Logging Limited completed project does not exist.
Checks at the Asuqua Municipal Assembly showed Bibiani Logging Limited was not part of the list of projects submitted to Accra by the Assembly. Authorities say they do not know the source of the project on the tracker. Meanwhile, it was found that a UniJ garment production company listed as completed was progressing from the ground stage. It was also learned that UniJ Fashion's existing edifice was used as a requirement in qualifying for a prudential bank loan of 12 million Ghana cedis under the One District, One Factory initiative to complete the current project. Government is assisting with a payment of half of the 20% interest on the loan. Jeanette Abobigu is Chief Executive Officer for UniJ Fashions.
When the government announced that One District, One Factory is coming, that time we also have this land. So we write our proposal to them and they understand us. So we send our proposal to our bank, which is Prudential Bank. So it's Prudential Bank who is financing the project. So the interest, the government is paying 10% and UniJ is also paying 10%.
When completed, the two-story edifice is expected to increase employment from the 150 currently to 250. Personnel will be recruited, trained and employed from the locality.
Garment industry is volumes, so you need a place that you get people who can come and work. And if you take like jute factory, brewery and other places, the people who were working there, they did not go, all of them are still in. So Kumasi Metro, like Asuqua Metro, there are a lot of people and the youth too are here. So that is why we built this here.
One major factor that will hinder progress of this government's flagship program 1D1F is this road network. In fact, it's the road leading from Ahinsan right through to the other end, but it truncates at the end of that road. It needs to be constructed for business to thrive. Reporting for Joy News, Erastus Asaridonko, Kumasi.